everybody, here's the board again. This time I've come with a video about Norse mythology. Well, it's the first video about it that I'm recording, and well, I hope you would like that. And well, this video is about a story from Norse mythology with the three main characters in the first. The first one is Odin, the old father that, well, I think all of the people know. And then there is Loki, the god of mischief, that more than all of the people know, because these two characters were already in Marvel Cinematic Universe. And well, after that there is Fafnir, that nobody knows. Well, I would explain all of this to you, so no problem. Now, after some seconds, we will give an introduction about all these three characters. So the first one, I would go with Fafnir because he's the most unknown one. Well, he's an ancient god of Aesir. He was very powerful, as they say, and he was the god of silence, passion, spirituality and poetry. Then we have Loki, the Loki's son. He was the god of mischief. Well, he tricked a lot of gods and a lot of people all around the Nine Realms. Then we have Odin, the Allfather, the god of magic, poetry, death, and also divination. So, now let's get started with this story. So, as the story says, there were three dwarf brothers, the son of Hreidmar, a dwarf king, and well, then the first son was Regin, who was kind of the wisest one. Then we had Fafnir, who is actually the main character and also the strongest of these three, and he used to guard his father's castle that was made of jewels and all kinds of precious things. Then we have poor Otter. Well, Otter was a dwarf, but in the day he was pretty much like a real otter, I mean the animal. And so one day Loki, Odin and Fafnir were going to Hreidmar's castle. On the way they see Otter. Well, what a cute Otter. Loki throws a stone and he kills Otter. Then they skin it and they bring the skin to Hreidmar's castle. And Hreidmar, well, they have killed his son. So he gets angry and he imprisons Loki, Odin and Fafnir. Then Fafnir and Odin say, well, it was Loki, so we didn't do anything. Then Hreidmar thinks a little and tells Loki to repay this thing. He has to fill the skin of his son with gold and then bring it back to him. Well, dwarves liked gold a lot. Anyway, Loki goes, finds Anvari, his gold and also his ring, and he steals them. And it's a completely another story, so let's stick to this one for now. He steals the gold, brings them to Hreidmar. And one thing I have to tell you is that Anvari's gold is cursed, and whoever owns that gold except Anvari, he gets cursed and he wants more and he gets paranoid about those golds. So when Loki brought the gold to Hreidmar, the sons also got cursed and they wanted the gold for themselves. So Regin and Fafnir set a plan and killed their own father to have the gold for themselves. But Fafnir wanted more, so he also killed his other brother Regin to have all the gold for himself. And well, because of the curse of the golds, he turned into a monster and he became a dragon. Then, well, all the Aesir gods tried to catch him and kill him, but well, the dragon was wiser and also he didn't want to lose his gold, so he escaped and went to the woods. But well, to enter the woods he had to get smaller, so he teared off his own wings so he could enter the woods. Then he entered, he spread a very poisonous fog into the jungle, and so nobody could enter the jungle to hurt him. And also the near villages around that jungle got a plague spread into them. Anyway, Actually, the story ends here with Zigfrid coming and killing the dragon, but that's again completely another story for another day. So push the subscribe button for more and like the video if you liked it. And remember, the boar is always watching you.